It's ClayTrader, and this will be a video chart on ticker symbol TRTC. We will take a look at the 60-minute time frame, and before I get started, I do want to note to please check my IRP disclaimer. So looking here, we have the 60-minute, and real quick, what that means, instead of each one of these candlesticks or bars, whatever you want to call them, representing one day's worth of price action, which is what you would normally see, each one just represents 1 hour's worth of price action or 60 minutes. The reason I wanted to focus on this time frame was I think it does a much better job of showing what's been going on and then what you want to see continue to happen going forward. But before we dig into this, I want to start on the daily chart, and we'll also end on the daily chart. The reason for that is I just want to point out that the chart acted exactly like you would want to see it act on Friday. And what do I mean by that? Well, let's first identify a very important level of support, and that comes in the form of what I'm going to call right here at 21 cents. So let's change this to green first to represent support, and then I'll explain where this came from. I'm going to make that line extra thick because it's a very important level of support. But if you look back here, you can see there's quite a bit of price history right around this 21 cents. Now, I realize that the price dropped below it a couple times here, but on that same token, there's a couple times where the price didn't quite go down that low, but hit right above it. So what I'm just trying to do is split the difference between, I guess, essentially 20 and 22 cents and just calling it 21 cents right there. So keep in mind where this green line came from, because when we go back to the 60-minute chart, it's still going to be there. I just want to point out where exactly that level is coming from. So hopping back down to the 60-minute chart, let's zoom in a little bit more now. And again, like I just noted, that green line is what we were just talking about. And you can see right here, the price came down and found support right on that area. Technically dropped a little bit below it, but you get the point. Right at this 21 cent area, the spot where you wanted to see resistance come in, it did come in. So that's a good sign. And it's good that, you know, the bulls were finally able to dig in and put an end to what the bears run in terms of putting the price, you know, downwards. Now, along with this, looking here at volume, and then combining that with candlestick here, it looks like we have a potential level of capitulation. When you look at the third dynamic of the candlestick, the volume, and then what is the price reaction after these two events, you can see that the price has started to head back upwards and put in higher highs. So that leads to the potential conclusion that we're looking at a possible level of capitulation right here on this final hour right here. You can see the big volume came in, candlestick, and then since then the price has been able to start to move upwards higher, as opposed to, you can see, for basically 4 hours straight the price was getting knocked down, but now it's starting to head back upward. So potential capitulation right here in this time frame. So that brings up, now where are these future levels of resistance for a continued bounce? And the first level that's sticking out is right here, and that is at 28 cents. Changes to red to represent resistance, and then we'll talk about where that comes from. You can see here the price, although didn't quite hit it, pretty close right there, bounced off it pretty close again. So 28 cents is the current level of resistance where if this bounce is going to continue, that's going to be the first level that you want to see the price get above. So far so good. The original area of resistance was right down here around 24.5 cents. Obviously that has been broken, so in order for this bounce to continue, obviously the price will need to put in higher highs and higher lows. So the next high that you want to get above and get some closes above is at 28 cents. Now after 28 cents, the next level of resistance that I would point out would be right here at 31 cents. And that comes from, looking back here, you can see acted as a support and resistance again. And then after this level, things really begin to thin out again, and I personally wouldn't call another level of support, or excuse me, resistance until up here, and we'll just name that up at 41 cents. So some pretty good bounce potential in there if these new highs can keep on getting put in. I think that level of resistance might pack more of a punch just because you also have the 50 period sloping downward. Not impossible to break, but given the history of it being a support over here, that'll be a very significant level of resistance to get through. But obviously, one step at a time, let's first see if the price can get above this 28 cents. But there is quite a bit of upside move or room here to move with these spaces in the resistances. That's kind of the one good thing about when prices really go down fast like this. It creates gaps in resistance level. Same is true when a stock is just going straight up. It creates gaps in support levels here. The opposite is happening. We have gaps here now in resistance levels where the price could really, you know, hopefully get moving quickly here. But for now, nice to see that volume has dropped off while it's going sideways, showing the potential forming of a bottom here. And then if we're looking at the really micro view, you can see that Obviously, we have 21 cent low here, then a higher low, and then even higher lows up here. So, you know, it's really starting to put in those higher lows on the micro frame if you want to look that close at it. But the point being, 21 cents is the key level of support, and it held like you wanted it to see hold. So obviously, you want to see it continue to hold going into the future. But in order for this current level or this current trend to keep on going, the next level that you're going to want to see is 28 cents broken, and then up here, and then things could really start to open up. So that is where the 60-minute chart ends. And then, like I said, I want to end on the daily chart. And I was talking about all these bounces. And the one thing is this chart has shown that it's happened before. The last time it was down in this area, you can see that it made a nice bounce there. And then even in a longer term view, made a bounce all the way up there. So the past history does show that it's happened before. So we'll see if history repeats itself. You know, as far as will it, all we can do at this point in time is just sit back and watch. But it has happened before, so let's see what happens. If there are any other questions on the chart, please let me know. If not, again, this was TRTC. Thanks for listening.